we have learned that verbs can be finite or non-finite, and that non-finite verbs are of three kinds: the infinitive, the participle, and the gerund. Today we will be learning about the gerund in greater detail. She is reading a book. Now in this sentence, what is the verb? Is reading is the verb in the sentence. Now is reading is a finite verb and shows an action in progress. But if I say reading improves your knowledge, then what are the verbs in this sentence? Now in this sentence, reading and improves are the two verbs here, where improves is the finite verb. But reading also denotes an action, where improves is the finite verb. Reading is a non-finite verb. Now this non-finite verb is an ing verb form and denotes an action. But this ing verb form, which denotes an action, if you notice carefully, is functioning as a noun in this sentence. What improves your knowledge? Reading improves your knowledge. So when we have an ing verb form that denotes an action, which is a non-finite verb and acts as a noun, then we call those verbs as gerunds. So what is a gerund? The ing form of a verb that denotes an action and behaves like a noun is known as a gerund. It is a non-finite verb that acts both as a noun and as a verb. Hence, it is often referred to as a verbal noun. Now let us look at this sentence. We are going hiking next month. Now what are the verbs in this sentence? Are going and hiking. Now going is an ing form of the verb and hiking is also an ing form of the verb. But if you read the sentence carefully, you will realize that are going refers to a particular action and it is a finite verb. Hiking refers to another action, and this action has been referred by an ing verb form which is acting as a noun. We are going what? We are going hiking. Hence, are going is the finite verb, but hiking is the gerund. So if you find an ing verb form, it is not necessary that it will be a gerund. Remember, for the verb to be a gerund, the ing verb form has to behave like a noun. Swimming in the summer is very refreshing. John looked for his swimming trunks everywhere. Let us first identify the verbs in the two sentences here. So in the first sentence, we have swimming as the non-finite verb and is as the finite verb. In the second sentence, we have looked as the finite verb and swimming as the non-finite verb. So we see that we have used the ing form of the verb swimming in both the sentences. Now, what is the difference in the usage? Let us see. In the first sentence, when we say swimming in the summer is very refreshing, what in the summer is very refreshing? Swimming in the summer is very refreshing. So the ing verb here functions as a noun. In the second sentence, John looked for his swimming trunks everywhere. Now when we say swimming trunks, do you think that swimming here is acting as an adjective? Is it describing the noun trunks? Let us see. When I say swimming trunks, does it mean trunks that are swimming? No, it does not mean that. So, swimming here is not acting as an adjective. What is it acting as? Now, swimming is a noun and trunks is a noun. So, swimming is the ing verb form, which is a part of a compound noun. So, swimming trunks together is a compound noun, and here swimming is a part of the compound noun. So, swimming in the first sentence is a gerund because it is acting as a noun. Now, in the second sentence also, it is a part of a compound noun. So, it is a noun. So, in the second sentence also, it is a gerund. Arguing solves nothing. The arguing couple kept the neighbors awake. Now, let us first identify the verbs in the two sentences here. So, in the first sentence, arguing solves nothing. Arguing is the non-finite verb and solves is the finite verb. In the second sentence, arguing is the non-finite verb and kept is the finite verb. Now, what is the difference in the way we have used arguing in both the sentences? Let us see. In the first sentence, arguing is an ing verb form which acts like a noun. What solves nothing? Arguing solves nothing. In the second sentence, arguing couple. So, arguing is the ing verb form which acts like an adjective. It is describing the noun couple. So, when we say arguing couple, we are meaning couple who is arguing. Hence, in the first sentence, arguing has been used as a gerund. In the second sentence, arguing has been used as a present participle. So, what do we understand? We understand that all verbs ending with ing are not gerunds. Only ing verb forms which act as nouns in a sentence are gerunds. Cycling is a popular sport. Cycling for an hour, the boy was tired. Let us first identify all the verbs in the two sentences here. Cycling is. In the second sentence, cycling was. Now, in the two sentences here, we see that the ing verb form has been used. But there is a difference in the usage. Let us see. In the first sentence, cycling is a popular sport. Is the finite verb. Now, cycling is the non-finite verb. It is the ing verb form which acts as a noun. What is a popular sport? Cycling is a popular sport. Hence, the ing verb form here is acting as a noun. So, it is a gerund. But in the second sentence, cycling for an hour, the boy was tired, was is the finite verb in this sentence. And cycling is the non-finite verb, which is the ing verb form. But this verb form shows an action in progress. Hence, cycling in this sentence is the present participle. So, we reiterate the fact that all verbs ending with ing are not gerunds. This is a very important point which you must remember. Now, let us identify the sentence with a gerund. We were debating on the next course of action. Debating is an art. Now, we know that a gerund is an ing verb form. So, what is the ing verb form in the sentences here? Debating. We know that for the ing verb form to be a gerund, it has to act like a noun. So, in which sentence does the ing verb form act like a noun? In the first sentence, we were debating on the next course of action. Does it act like a noun? No. In this sentence, were debating is showing an action in progress. In the second sentence, debating is an art. Does it act like a noun? Yes. In the second sentence, the ing verb form acts like a noun. What is an art? Debating is an art. So the second sentence has the gerund. Now let us read this sentence. The travelers were tired on account of having walked for so long. Now in this sentence, what are the verbs? Were and having walked. Now if I ask, the travelers were tired on account of what? On account of having walked. So having walked here is a verb form which is behaving like the noun. Hence this is behaving like a gerund. Now this is an example of a compound gerund. What is a compound gerund? Compound gerunds are ing verb forms of have along with the past participle of a verb. Now in this sentence we have the ing form of the verb have along with the past participle form of the verb walk. So here the compound gerund having walked is behaving like a noun. Now if I were to say, having walked for so long, the travelers were tired. Now I am essentially meaning the same thing in both the sentences. So in the second sentence, is having walked is behaving like a compound gerund? Think and see. If you see, having walked here is not behaving like a noun. So in the second sentence, having walked is the perfect participle. So in the first sentence, having walked is behaving like a noun, hence it is a compound gerund. In the second sentence, it is not behaving like a noun and hence it is the perfect participle. He hates being punished for no reason. This is another example of a compound gerund where we have used the ing form of the be verb along with the past participle form of the verb punish. So he hates what? He hates being punished. Here being punished is the compound gerund because it is behaving like a noun. Now let us do this exercise. Fill in the blank with an appropriate compound gerund. Her baby loves dash and the verb given to us is hold. Now we know that compound gerunds are formed with the ing form of the be verb or the have verb. What will we be using? Will we be saying her baby loves being held or having held? We will say her baby loves being and then the past participle form of the verb hold, held. So our compound gerund in this sentence is being held. So we have her baby loves being held. So what did we learn today? So today we have learned about the non-finite verb which are gerunds. What are gerunds? They are ing verb forms which show an action but they behave like nouns in a sentence. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. You can also register for free at deltastep.com or download the DeltaStep app to get all learning resources as per ICSE, CBSE, IB, Cambridge or any other curriculum. Over 5,000 amazing lectures across maths, science, English and social science. Our unique interactive video technology keeps you engaged and our iDictionary feature allows you to quickly revise any concept. Master each topic at your own pace with our adaptive practice technology and 1 million plus questions. Get instant answers and detailed solutions. Be exam ready by taking unlimited mock tests, performance analysis with actionable feedback, personal tutors to resolve your slightest of doubts. That's not all. You can also win amazing prizes like PlayStation, iPad, watches, and many more, along with certificates through our Earn As You Learn program. So learning at DeltaStep is not just fun and easy, it is also rewarding. So register for free now.